Hi everyone, and welcome to another Explorer tutorial. We hope you are enjoying Explorer. If you haven't tried it yet, feel free to download it from our website. Today, we are going to demonstrate IO Manager to help you manage your sound system. Let's get into the tutorial. Let's start by opening Hardware in the Explorer tab. And now let's talk about all the tabs available in the IO Manager. First, starting with audio hardware, here you can select your audio interface, also the sample rate and the buffer size. It's very interesting, we also display here the delay introduced in your system dependent on the sample rate and the buffer size. In the output buses section, you can route the channels of each bus according to the outputs available in your audio interface. You can even route them with different levels, selecting these icons on the right-hand side. And also the last one can be set as a customized gain. It is also possible to add new buses. You can add a name and change the format for whatever you are looking for. In this case, let's set a 7.1 format. Now our bus is created and we can change it as we go. Every time a new audio is selected with a different format, it automatically adds a new bus in the output buses section. At the bottom, we have a checkbox for a binaural monitoring option, as well as the bass management. As you can see, the LFE channel is replaced by the subwoofer. Also in Ambisonics buses, we have an Ambisonics decoder, which will change to the format set in the Ambisonics decoder tab. As you can see, now we have a second order Ambisonics being decoded to a 5.1 bus. In the Ambisonics decoder, it's possible to set the output format for the Ambisonics buses. Now the Ambisonics bus is being decoded to LCR instead of the 5.1, and in the stereo option, you can also set an XY or mid-side configuration. In the bass management tab, first of all, we have a block diagram which turns blue with a mouse over in each section. In the main section, it's possible to enable and disable a high pass filter for the main channels. We can change the filter frequency as well as the slope. We can have up to an 8th order of Butterworth or Linkwitz Riley filter. In the mains to subwoofer, we can enable or disable sending the main channels to the subwoofers with the same filters as before. We also have an option of a customized gain and a polarity inversion, as well as a link with mains frequency, creating a crossover filter between the two. As you can see now, when you change one frequency, both filters change at the same time. In the LFE section, it is possible to send the LFE to the subwoofer, to ignore the LFE, send the LFE to the left and right channels, or send the LFE to all main channels. We also have a low pass filter here with a customizable frequency and slope, as well as a gain and polarity inversion. Lastly, there is a master subwoofer section with a gain and polarity inversion. In the binaural monitoring tab, we have an option to select the dataset that we want to use. We already have some stock datasets, and within each dataset, it's possible to select a subject. It is also possible to import your own responses. As you can see now, the folder path is shown, but it's also possible to go back to another dataset and we get a message saying that our response is not in use anymore. Then we can also go back to the response we have stored. The control room allows you to optimize, fine-tune and debug eventual problems that you might have in your system. Here you can assign delays for different speakers. It's possible to change the delay unit from time in milliseconds to length in meters. It's also possible to set different gains for the output channels, as well as sending noise for each individual channel to identify the speakers in your system. It's also possible to have each output muted or soloed. As this is only for debug, every time we leave the control room, these mute and solo options are reset. At the bottom, we have a master section with a mute and dim option, as well as a master volume. IO Manager also includes a preset system. These presets will store the preferences that you assigned in all the windows except for the audio hardware. In the top right corner, you can find this section. We can create a new preset, remove the current preset, rename, import or export presets if you want to take them to another computer. Let's create a new preset called IO Manager Tutorial. And now let's make some changes so we can recall the preset later. So I will put here just some random values. Now let's go to the Binaural Monitoring and select this setting. In the base management, I will put everything in the maximum position, just so it's easy to identify when we recall it. Let's apply here some output assignments. And now let's save the preset. As you can see, we are prompted with a window asking if we want to create a new preset or save in this one. So I will go back to the previous preset. As you can see, nothing changed in the audio hardware, and we have the previous preset as we had before with all the default settings. Now let's select the preset that we just created. As you can see, now we have the settings stored in the preset. Everything in the maximum, in the base management. We have all the changes that we made here previously. It's also possible to use the arrows in the top to change between the presets that we have here. And as you can see, the base management also includes a presets section. Here we have the same menus. We can create specific presets only to the base management. Now, to differentiate them, let's put everything in the minimum position. After putting everything in the minimum, let's save this base management preset. We have the same window as before, asking if we want to save or create a new one. And then when we go back to the other IO Manager preset, we have a warning because we haven't saved changes. Because we went to the previous preset, all the parameters went to their previous value. And then when we go back to the IO Manager tutorial preset in the base management, everything goes back to the minimum as it was stored. Lastly, in the presets list of the IO Manager, you can see that there's an asterisk now indicating that there was a change. Thank you all for watching. Feel free to give us your feedback in the comment section. You can download Explorer from the link in the description or from our website for free. Thank you once again and take care.